This video is going to show you how to take some screen captures that you can use in other programs like PowerPoint or something like that. What I'm going to do here is show you how to take a screen capture of the opening credits of a film. In this case, it's going to be the opening credits to Food Inc. There's some wonderful little bits here. And let's say I want to do this where they've created their own credits using a grocery store sign. So let's say I want to take this as a screen capture. The easiest way to do this in some ways is to just use print screen. And on a Mac, you can see here, it's Command plus Shift plus 3. And then on a PC, you usually just press the print screen key, it's just looks like print and then SCRN. But this is in a different place on every computer, every keyboard. It's usually in the upper right-hand corner of your screen, though. So when you do this, what you're going to see is that you can simply press print screen. So I'm going to do that here. And then I'm going to go into Microsoft Word, and I'm going to press Control V to paste, or right-click, and then paste this in. Now, what this is going to do is I've got two windows here open, so it's going to actually give me both of those, which is not really what I want. So you'd have to then crop it out yourself. But with most of you, you're only having one screen, and that would be the only issue. So I'm going to delete that out. The other thing you can do is press Alt plus Print Screen. So in that case, what I would do is press Alt and then Print Screen at the same time. And that's going to be of the active window. And in this case, it was Microsoft Word. So when I paste this in, it's going to give me an image of the Microsoft Word thing there. If I'm clicked on Food Inc. and then I press Alt and then Print Screen and then paste it in, you see I have it with the VLC media player in there. And I don't think that looks very good, so I would say that that's probably not the best way to do it, but it is one of the easiest. You can also do this with QuickTime. If you're on a Mac, you can actually use that to record different elements, and you can see here in this support document from Apple. So you can go to this web address if you want. It shows you how to record your computer screen, and it's really easy. You just go to File and then New Screen Recording if that's what you want to do. Although I'm on a PC, so I'm not really going to show you how to do that. I think one of the easier ways to do this is to simply use another program. And there's on a PC with Windows, you can use the snipping tool, and you can just click on the little Start menu button, and then go to Run and then type in Snip, or in the search program you can just type in Snip and it'll bring this up. And then you can go to New, and what it will do is it'll actually make a little cursor here and make everything go white, and whenever I drag, it will record and take a little picture of it and then save that picture for you. It saves it, I think, in your Pictures file folder, but I'm not sure about that. What I tend to do when I'm looking at images like this is I use my media player itself, and I use VLC media player, VideoLAN. If you're going to use VideoLAN, make sure you download it from this address. So go to www.videolan.org, and you can do this for both Mac or PC. I highly recommend this player, it's fantastic. And you want to download it. Once you've downloaded it, you can open your files and they'll look like this. And then you want to go into Tools and go to Preferences. When you're in Preferences, you click on Video. And the only thing I'm doing here is I'm changing where these video pictures are saved, just because it's such a pain in the butt, because it saves them within its own file. And PNG is fine, it doesn't really matter, but you can change it to a JPEG if you want for some reason. Then I'm going to go to Browse and then go to my desktop. I tend to prefer to save things to the desktop, but you can save it wherever you want. But note this prefix, it's VLC snap. I would leave this alone, because if you want to search for your files afterwards, it's really easy to do that. And you can turn on sequential numbering so that it tells you, if you take 4 or 5 or 6, it tells you when you took those. And that's a really useful thing. So I'm going to save it. And then when you're playing something, you can just pause it. And then you can actually go to, video, I think it is. And then you do take snapshot. And then it will simply take a picture of whatever's in here, and then you can insert that into PowerPoint or whatever. It's a very, very useful tool. If you don't want to do that, there's other things you can do. And one of the programs that I like is to use Sketch. And it's a free program, evernote.com/sketch. A lot of you use Evernote to take notes on, and Sketch is kind of an integrated thing there, and you can put in little, you can see animations, you can put in little arrows and logos and things like that. That makes Sketch very useful for just image editing or for useful images. Although all of the stuff you can also do in PowerPoint, so I don't really find it all that useful necessarily for the kind of applications you're probably going to be doing. Videoland for me is my favorite, especially when I'm taking screen captures of a DVD or something like that. Once you're done, you can just drag those images right into PowerPoint and you're good to go. Thanks.